Howdy friends, and welcome to All About Relay channel. In this video, we will be seeing how to create the harmonic waveform using the Excel sheet. This video turned to be a longest video. So guys, if you want to get into the subject matter directly to how to create using Excel, please start from the 22 seconds. But I would strongly recommend, like, someone want to learn more about it, that understands some other stuffs about the harmonic, please watch the full videos, and please add the comment at the after watching the video. I hope it is helpful to you. Let's get into the video. As we discussed earlier, we are going to use this Excel sheet for creating the waveforms, different waveforms like fundamental frequency waveform, second harmonic waveform, third harmonic waveform, or nth harmonic waveforms, and also like we can visualize how each frequency waveforms looks like under combination of this resultant waveform, how it looks like. It's very important to visualize the harmonic waveforms for the testing and commissioning engineers to see how the relay looks, the harmonic inputs when doing measurement. And also, it gives the idea like how the relay test kits inject the harmonic waveform, right? It generate the fundamental frequency waveform, second harmonic waveform, and it like kind of superimpose it and deliver the output. So the resultant output. So what we are going to see, we create independent waveforms and we combine each waveform and visualizing it how the waveform looks like. We have multiple tabs here. Formulas tab, harmonic DM, this is my name, and harmonic development tab. So we are going to use the harmonic development tab for creating it. This particular tab, it's already created, which I'm going to show even before we start the test. And the most importantly, any testing and commissioning engineer or any production engineer need to understand how the harmonic waveform or sinusoidal waveform is generated. We are going to use these two basic waveforms equation, like I is equal to I max times sine 2 phi ft. Frequency in this case f t, phi is the constant. And also in case of the nth harmonic waveform, like in times I max sine n is like, what is that number of harmonic? 2 phi ft. So we will see how we can create the second harmonic, third harmonic, fifth harmonic, or nth harmonic based on this waveform. And also like how we combine them, actually the vector addition of this I plus in equal to the resultant waveform. So that also we will see. The most importantly, power system engineers or testing and commissioning engineer need to understand before going for the testing any harmonic elements, the most important part is the phase angle of relationship for the harmonic. So this gives some idea. The 50 hertz by default, or generally it is a positive sequence waveform. If the 100 hertz, this is a reference to 50 hertz, so the second harmonic in this case 100 hertz, that is negative sequence. Say example, your positive sequence is defined with the balance phase angle of 0 minus 120 plus 120. In this case, negative sequence is 0, 120 minus 120. You need to give the right phase angle for creating the right balanced fundamental plus harmonic waveform. We can see, visualize it, what will happen if you give the different frequency with the different phase angle not appropriate, how the phase, the resultant waveform looks collapsed. The third harmonic waveform, or most of the odd harmonic waveforms, are like a zero phase sequence or zero sequence. The nth harmonic, it is like an even harmonic, is a positive sequence. And also like the 250 hertz, it's like it's a negative sequence. The 300 hertz is a zero sequence. 350 hertz is the positive sequence. And also like this is some example how harmonic effects based on the sequence components, harmonic sequence components present in the power system. I already put one video before like about the harmonics part one. and also the phase sequence, please go through those videos. It gives some idea the significance of the phase angle rotation and also the how harmonic affects the power system equipments. So let us go to the this tab actually and see what it is here. So by already I have defined the parameters for a fundamental frequency. In this case, like delta is nothing but like the time difference between the each sample, you know, like sinusoidal waveform, like it's 60 hertz. So in this case, reference is 60 hertz. So it's like one by 60 is like 16.67 millisecond. Within that 16.67 millisecond, how many samples we are taking, we can define it. But in this case, I created each step with a delta of 0.1 seconds actually. And fundamental frequency I max here, I defined 5 amps and frequency is like 60 hertz. The I2 in this case is second harmonic I consider. Its amplitude is 1 amps. The harmonic frequency is 120 hertz because of the second harmonic reference to 60 hertz system. And second harmonic constant is 2 because it's 2 times, or like any harmonic constant is 2. When you are try to draw the harmonics in the time domain basins instead of like a theta or instead of using the phase angle, but you use direct time domain basis, then you can use the harmonics with the multiplication of 2. It will work for every single harmonic. We will see when you create it. The third harmonic frequency I created, I said 180 hertz because of 60 hertz is reference. The time constant, if you see here, it's nothing but since I'm going to define the sinusoidal waveform with the omega t, like we see like sine omega t or like 2 phi f t. Omega is like nothing but 2 phi f. So I'm going to use 2 phi f. So it's a time domain basis we are going to use it. So I calculated, I'm using the formula like 60 hertz, it's 1 by, you can see here, I'm converting into millisecond. So 1 by b4 is nothing but here 60 hertz, and 1 by b4 and calculated 60 hertz, what is the equivalent time? It's the same I calculated for second harmonic or third harmonic. And I3 here is the magnitude for the third harmonic element, that's a 0.5. So the fundamental is 5 amps in current amplitude, and a second harmonic amplitude is 1 amps, that is close to 20%. Then this is I3 is 10%. So you can see here third harmonic constant also keep 2 because of the constant I keep same. So the phase angle here, if you notice, the phase angle also I calculated. The phase angle for like fundamental frequency 0, 120, 240, sorry, in this case 0, negative 120, plus 120, and the equivalent time constant I calculated here. We will see on the next step how we are calculating. The second harmonic I used like 0, 120, 240. Remember, the second harmonic components are negative phase sequence. If you reverse the phase sequence component, it will collapse your resultant waveform, and you will not get the right resultant waveform. I will, in the short while, I will show in the wave in the chart how it looks like. The third harmonic waveform, it's a zero sequence component, so all the phase angles I keep zero to maintain the zero sequence. So I calculated the values based on this parameter and draw the waveform. So we are going to create a step-by-step how we are going to draw the waveform, but I already created. Let us view the waveform, how it looks like. So here we have like 3 harmonics, 3 fundamental waveform, and also 3 combined waveform we need to see based on this value. So here this is like a phase fundamental waveform. So then let's see what are the A phase. I already created or mapped every single waveforms into the chart. So just we need to enable it. So let's see A phase fundamental, how A phase second harmonic looks like. So you can see here when I enable the A phase second harmonic, there are 2 peaks appear within the one within the fundamental. So basically what it says, the second harmonics is 2 times faster than your fundamental frequency are twice time faster. In this case, why I say it's faster, it's because of the time reference. I'm saying referring to time, because like this is 60 hertz. That is like it takes like one full cycle takes 16.67 milliseconds, but the second harmonic take 8.33 milliseconds. That's why within a one single peak, you see the two peak. Example, in case of third harmonic, it's a thrice the fundamental, right? Then it will see three peaks. If it is a fourth harmonic, you will see the four peak within the one half cycle. That's how you will differentiate between the harmonics and fundamental frequency waveform. So like we see the second harmonic, I want to see what is my third harmonic on the A phase, because I already created. Let me pick the third harmonic here. Let me find out what is the third harmonic. So here, A phase third harmonic. You see here, as I said earlier, the A phase third harmonic have three peaks within the one half cycle of the fundamental frequency. That means the third harmonic is three times faster than the fundamental frequency waveform. This, since we are looking in the power system wall, so we say like it's in terms of frequency and in terms of theta, but this also applied to the sound profile. So this is like we can refer as a faster also. So let me change this color as like same as the A phase waveform. So I fill this color with red color. So then everything looks same. So A phase fundamental waveform, then this is a second harmonic waveform. This is third harmonic waveform. So when the system have this frequency, three frequency waveform present in the system, how the resultant waveform looks like? Let us enable how the resultant waveform. Here I say like A phase compo, that is a combination of the waveform. This is the resultant waveform. If I enable this one, you can see here, this is how it looks like. When the second harmonic, third harmonic, fundamental frequency waveform looks like, this is how it looks like. So basically, the second harmonic and third harmonic mixed with the fundamental frequency, the sinusoidal waveform certainly separate. So this is the challenge for the relays in the real world scenario, processing this signal. You can see here, real sinusoidal waveform, fundamental frequency goes here, the power system frequency. But with the frequency influences, this waveform collapses here. So this is going to be hard. Sometime the waveform, the value over here is not really seen by relay. It's seen here. So it may do the false measurement. Say example, plane time, the amplitude, you can see it may be like 3.8 something, but the equivalent time, the actual with the harmonic influence, it may be 4.5. So the relay may see the wrong value or premature value and operated. That's the main purpose. Most of the very sensitive or unit production relays like transformer differential relay, it included with the second harmonic production, third harmonic or nth harmonic production or harmonic resistance, harmonic block, whatever it is, the way depends on the application we are producing the harmonics. It's very important to understand for us while testing, also for relay to understand, measure it, and predict what is the actual fundamental waveform before by separating the harmonic components. So every modern numerical relays have this ability. In case of olden days, if you remember testing the electromechanical relays, what we used to do, parallel the two frequency waveform, like give the harmonic waveform, then fundamental frequency waveform one input from the one output of test set, and the second current output you parallel to the same terminal, but it gives you the second multiple way create the harmonic waveform. But modern relay test kits like SMRT relays, SMRT relay test kit can generate the single output with the superimposing waveform using RTMS software. We will see in the different sessions. But in this case, so we will get to know like how the harmonic waveforms looks like. So back to our thing, we see A phase, how it looks like. Let us disable the A phase here in the view. we will start seeing in this B phase, like the phase B. So I will enable the B phase fundamental frequency, B phase harmonic frequency, and B phase like third harmonic frequency. Okay. So here you can see here B phase, it starts from the negative 120 degree. That's why it started from here. It's a fundamental waveform. You see two peak within the one, the fundamental, then it is a second harmonic. If you see three peak within the fundamental, that's a third harmonic. Let me change this color to match the fundamental. So it's a B phase third harmonic. So let's see how the resultant waveform looks like. The combination of this fundamental and a second harmonic and third harmonic. Here, C phase, B phase combo. So you can see it's supposed to look similar to the A phase, but 120 degree of what? It is very, very important. The waveform shape of all three phase should be importantly correct. Otherwise, the relay will maloperate for a different phase combination. So we will see how most of the most common mistakes when the relay test kit generating the harmonic waveform influences the relay maloperation, or even relay firmwares or algorithms sometimes do wrong measurement. We will see by changing the phase angle when we are looking into the resultant waveform as a three phase. So we see the B phase, like let's go on C phase. Like I uncheck here all the A phase, B phase, B phase signals. Then I will enable first C phase fundamental, C phase second harmonic, and C phase third harmonic. So in this case, like you see three phase waveform. This is start from the plus 120 degree. Let's change the color of this harmonic waveform to blue. Or this is a different blue, looks like. Yeah. So here, the fundamental frequency waveform, one peak, you see the second harmonic have a two peaks and third harmonic have a three peak. So that means this is look very nice and it's a proper. Like then we go like see the resultant waveform, how it looks like, select data. And I'm going to enable the C phase combination, right? So this also you can see like C phase, it looks like similar to safe. You will get confused which one is. This is the fundamental frequency. You can move this one. This is the C phase combo. This is the resultant waveform. So now this is how relays will integrate the fundamental frequency, second harmonic or third harmonic or any harmonic signals. It combine and produce the resultant harmonic. And also it calculate THD, that is called the total harmonic distortion. That is a very important factor in the power quality analyzer measurement. That part we are not discussing here, but that's important to know when we are testing those type of relays or meters. So in this case, like we see like a three C phase waveform, everything is good. So now, let's see, like we eliminate all the harmonic fundamental waveform just to see only the resultant waveform, all the three phases. Let me select here. So A phase combination is the resultant waveform. I uncheck C phase fundamental second harmonic, and I enable the B phase combination and also disable the C phase harmonic. That means it's only we have A, B, C phase, the resultant waveform. Like this is how the frequency looks like when you have the third harmonic component present, second harmonic component present, your resultant waveform looks like this. So let us play around, like how if you have only one frequency waveform, like we don't have any third harmonic present. So let's see how it looks like. You see here, we automatically see the waveform, it changes, right? It does present only with the second harmonic component up to like 20%. Say example, like I'm changing equal to like, say example, 50%, that is like 2.5 amps. So you can see here the waveform, it changes, but it's grown. Since it's the same growth, we don't notice, but it changed the amplitude. Let me change back to the 20%. That's a 1 amps, and we will come back. You can see here. Then I'm going to set the third harmonic as a 10%, that is 0.5 amps. So it produces this. So we will See, in case like your phase angle, the test kit not applying correctly, or when we are calculating the harmonic components, we don't consider the phase angle correctly for the second harmonic component and third harmonic component, what will happen? So what I mean to here, our fundamental frequency balance phase angle is 0 minus 120 plus 120. So I put here the second harmonic selection is my phase angle is 0, 120 minus 120, which is negative sequence of fundamental. Say example, you apply 0 1, minus 120 plus 120. This is positive sequence. You can see our waveform looks really, really wrong. This is absolutely wrong. So the waveform is got collapsed. So it means like the waveform does not draw correctly, and the resultant vector it generate it output wrongly. So here you can clearly see A phase maybe looks okay, B and C phase is wrong. So it indicates how important for the harmonic to apply the correct phase angle for any relay test kit in the world to testing or generating the harmonic waveform. So let's change back our second harmonic phase angle to the negative phase sequence, 0, 120 and minus 120 in this case. So you will get the waveforms correctly. Then let's see, so instead of zero sequence, let's apply third harmonic some positive sequence component. In this case, positive sequence is 0, negative 120 and plus 120. So if you notice here, now this also looks different actually. It's not the real resultant. The one thing you can commonly notice when your phase angles of fundamental frequency and harmonic components present in that resultant waveform not aligned with its sequence component properties, your peaks never match. This is the simple classic example of the resultant components won't appear correctly. In on real world, this peaks also mismatch, not because of the phase angle components are different or sequence components are different. There is one factor, it's called DC offset. When there is a DC offset present, it switches the waveform or it shifts the phase waveform location in different position. So we will see that differently in this. Maybe in the next video, I will add the influence of DC offset on the waveforms output or measurement of the relay. So let's go back here and I put the zero sequence component correctly for the third harmonic. So then you can see the real waveform looks perfectly nice. So this is looks. All the resultant waveform. If you change, like even you can do one thing here. You can also play with you change the frequencies here, and you can do it. That we will do in the next tab actually, which we are going to practically generating it. I'm going to display how I'm generated this particular waveform step by step. Let's see how we can develop our own waveforms actually, what I saw. So to create the waveform, I create some predefined table. So it's empty. You can see nothing is here, no chart, nothing. So we are going to use this two waveform equations like I equals I max times sine 2 phi ft. This is a fundamental sinusoidal waveform equation, right? Then it's a harmonic waveform. It's n times 2 phi ft on sine. It is like a harmonic waveform. So here I created the delta t that is like 0.1 second. Every samples I want to create with 0.1 second. So the first column here is hours is time. So you add time t. So the you start from zero obviously. Then you can add the second one, like here. If you see the second one, F5 is the first one. This is the F column and row 5, F5 plus B2 actually. In this case, delta, it's a B column and the 2 is the value 0.1. But I'm not going to change this value, so I won't lock it. So if you press function F4 key or direct F4 key, this cell get locked. Then once you get locked, you can select this corner and the plus sign. You drag it down and it will create all the rows correctly based on the equations. And I select up to like 402 in this case. So to create the waveform, so we define the time now. Okay, so before creating the tables for phase A, phase B, phase C, let us understand what are the components we are going to create. So I have the three major column here, B, C, D, F1, F2, F3, it's three different frequencies. In this case, like magnitude for each frequency is 5, F1 is 5, F2 is 1, that is 20%, and F3 in this case 0.75, that is a 15%. So my frequency for F1, that of F1 is like 60 Hz. That means in this example, I'm considering 60 Hz as my fundamental frequency. That is here, it is defined as a F1. My F2 is defined as 120 Hz. That is nothing but like a second harmonic frequency. F3 here is 180 Hz. This is like third harmonic frequency. And harmonic constant for the fundamental frequency is 1. Any harmonic constant you will keep 2, since it is I'm using the time domain. So and also like I need to calculate time constant, right, for creating my waveform, like sine 2 phi f t. Here t you need to calculate, or means phi and f calculation you need to have. Instead of going to use 60, I'm going to use time domain for the 1 by t is my f. That's what I'm going to use. That's why I calculated here. You will see in the formula. Then phase angle for my fundamental frequency is 0, negative 120 plus 120. Please refer to one of my video, phase sequence video. I'm talking about like, what is the zero reference phase angle? Say example, your VA is 0 degree and you will reach the point of max voltage, peak voltage that time. So please refer to the video. When I post this video, I will post two links for the phase sequence videos and the harmonic previous session video in the description. Yeah, the A phase time constant is 0 in this case. So we have built the waveform for the A phase fundamental frequency. So we are okay with that. Now we need to add all the points to create the fundamental frequency waveform. So what I do here, I drag this time domain signals to the max of time. So it will add the test points. So once the points are added, so I want to see whether, so these points are added. So this is the sinusoidal waveform test point. So I want to add these points in the curve. So you can see here, it's already been mapped, right? So what I can do, like select data, in your case, like you guys select data, and in this case, A phase F1, here F1, that's our frequency, what we selected. Then I press edit to show you guys actually what are the values created. It's copied here, the series values. I named the series name as A phase F1. So it's clearly shows like that's A phase fundamental waveform. I click OK here. Now let's go to the second harmonic waveform for A phase. How to create that? It's pretty similar to it's exactly same, and only the values are get changed. So the B column is used for the fundamental frequency, and the C column we are going to use for the second harmonic frequency. It's exactly same parameter, but the time constant get changes because of the frequency 120 hertz, and all of the stuffs are pretty much same. So what I'm going to do, so it's the second harmonic waveform is good. So I drag this value and add all the test points. So once all the test points are added, so we need to add into the chart. Like how we add to into the chart, like here in the chart, right click, select data, and since I already got it, so it's there. So I select A phase F2, then I press edit. So here I go click on like edit option. So here I need to pick my edit option. This is my second harmonic waveform value. So this I edit, and I we can, oops, sorry, this is A phase F1. So I cancel this one. I select F2, then edit it. F2, like then I select this one. So it is selected correctly already. So I click OK. Then I OK here. Then it will start gender the second harmonic waveform. You can see, since it is it's only shows one waveform, you don't differentiate it. But you can see it's a very short time the waveform is created. Let's keep going, and we will generate the third harmonic signal. Third harmonic here is a third column, actually, sorry, fourth column, D column. So it's a similar to the same parameter, current value and the harmonic time constant and the actual time constant and phase angle compensation values. So once it's added, you drag these values here. Then, so your values get added. Once your values get added, go back to the chart here, right click, and you see it's already appearing the second harmonic, third harmonic. To confirm that A phase F3, so here let's see, A phase F3 is here, then edit. Just want to make sure, I want to make sure we are on the right one, A phase F3, edit. So here select, so this is like, selected with the third harmonic waveform. This is perfectly correct. Okay, so I uncheck this one F3 for now, and click okay. So we don't have any waveform selected. I want to combine these three waveforms. It's like the one good thing about Excel is this, the fundamental second harmonic, third harmonic, it has been already the vector value. So when you simply add the sum of all the three, it will become vector addition. So I drag this value here. It will start adding all the values here. Fill the table value. So once this table value is filled, so I go back to this the chart. I want to see how the harmonic fundamental the combinations work. So I go back here, AFS compo, and edit. Just want to make sure I have the right value. So I get a right value. And you can see here already the drawing, the chart appears with the AFS harmonic waveform. That looks pretty nice with the mixed harmonic waveform. So let's build the B phase actually. So B phase, so it's pretty similar to the what we did for AFS. In your case, I would strongly recommend copy this, all the four, and paste it here. And simply pick only one channel. What are the difference will be? No amplitude changes for the fundamental frequency, no time constant changes, but the one changes will be the phase angle time constant, right? So instead of 0 degree, we will be going minus 120 degree. That equivalent value is minus 5.55 milliseconds. So that is get added. So that correction you do, so then it will get added. So to add into, to fill the table, so you drag the values here and fill the table. So you want to make sure these values are appear here. This is the B phase fundamental. So let's go to select data. Just want to make sure B phase fundamental here. I press edit. So here B phase fundamental is nothing but here we have to name this as a B phase fundamental edit. So this is not a fundamental. In our case, we name, you remember we named as F1. So F1 is our fundamental frequency, F1. So here I have to pick this one. It is going to the previous sheet. So I'm going to take here the fundamental waveform for B phase here. We select this is the value, right value. Once your table is done, so you can see B phase fundamental, click OK. Then OK, now the B phase fundamental value get, okay, something is not correct. So it's not drawing it correctly. So let's see the equation, B phase fundamental. So the values are looks correct, minus 15. So let's make sure it is correct values. It's correct. So here, select data, then B phase F1, edit, B phase of F1, select the variables, So here F1, correct values we need to select. Just want to make sure okay, so it should draw the good sinusoidal waveform. So we need to fix what is the problem. Something is wrong with the equation. Let's fix this the waveform issue. Probably we might mismatch one of the values. So let's look into this. Here, what is wrong? Yeah, you can see here the waveform, any waveform should start from time domain. I had a wrong value, so it is F column, not J column. So this one actually, the Fi also we can lock, you can put like function F4. When you lock this value, then when you're copy pasted, then it won't get changed. That's the one thing you can do. So let's define the test points or sine wave points. It should create the fundamental waveform for B phase correctly. It doesn't create it correctly. So okay, so I'm sorry, this one not here, F dollar, because we need to define the values correct. My bad, so please don't do that. So F5, so it will redraw that, because it draw the if you notice, it was drawing the solid line instead of sine waveform. Now you can see the fundamental waveform comes back. Since it's a B phase, I'm going to change the color. Here, outline to yellow. Then now we got a fundamental frequency waveform. Let's define the harmonic. Probably it's the same problem here. I fixed this one, Fi. It sounds like all other parameter for B phase is correct. You can see here, B phase only change we need to have is conversion time for phase angle. That is looks correct. So let's build this one. So we have the values, but we need to map with the chart. So let's select the data. I want to make sure like we are not looking for B phase F1. So we are looking for B phase second harmonic, but we need to rename it, edit this one. So it's not a second harmonic. So let me click inside. You have to click inside. It's a trick in Excel. You need to make sure you are in the right location. So B phase F2. So I put the colon to understand. We need to select the value because it's another tab. We need to select the common values from this tab. So this is the value we need to pick. So B phase harmonics. So it picked two times. Let us select once again because it was wrongly selected two times. So to avoid the confusion, so we make sure we selected once again correctly. So these are all problems you are going to see it when you are practically building the Excel sheet with the waveform generation. So it looks okay. Let's go back and see how the waveform looks like in the B phase. So here it looks nice. So let me change the color to match the other B phase values. And let's go back and build the third harmonic quick. So here it is the same problem. I see it's AFI. So let's build the, since it's zero, you will know when it is zero, it's a phase angle or the for harmonic values is zero because the phase angle for this one is zero. So that is correct. So go back and build. Here, select data and go to B phase. We need to have a B phase third harmonic. In this, in our case, it is F3. So I name this as a F3, and this one we change from other tab to here. It's already selected automatically. So I click OK. So it's something wrong. So let's pull this one again. So you need to practically experience it, then you can able to achieve the results. So B phase F3. So we can see here. So waveform is generated. I will change the color again. The waveform. So I put, since it's a B phase, I put yellow color. Save the file. So now we got a fundamental frequency also. So what we have to do, we have to add all these three waveforms to get the combination of the resultant waveform. So we do have the addition. So here I sum all the values. Just we have to map it here, select data. It's like a B phase compo, right? So I will uncheck the B phase F3. If it's compo, we select edit, and instead of harmonic page tab, we need to use the development tab here. So this one, this is the value we need to pick. Here, so we should have the second harmonic of resultant waveform. It should look similar to A phase. So this looks similar to A phase earlier what we selected. I changed the color to yellow. So I may do some fast forward and I will come up with selecting the correct phase for C phase also. But let me quickly fix this one. So what I will do, C phase F5, B13, this all looks correct. Second harmonic, C4. This is here actually. C phase is something like you can see here conversion. That's the main difference you will be seeing here. So this second harmonic also C phase is correct. Then I go for third harmonic, that also C phase is correct. The combined is correct. So the one advantage, in once you have these values correct, you can able to generate the waveform for all the four correctly. That's one big advantage of this one. In Excel. So once you added all the test points, you save the file, and we need to map into the chart. So select data. So I want to make sure all the I will uncheck the B phase compo, and I want to say C phase fundamental. I just selected edit this one. It is not a fundamental anymore. It is a C phase F1. According to our table. So this is coming from another table if you see. So we want to map it to our table here. So I select here, this is the C phase fundamental. It's a 60 hertz sinusoidal waveform it should create. Okay, so let's see whether it is created C phase waveform. Yeah, it just looks a 60 hertz fundamental waveform. Let's create the harmonic. We can also create everything all together, but I'm doing one by one to avoid any mistake. So I uncheck C phase, so C phase second harmonic. I edit this one, and I rename this as F2, C phase F2, and select the values in this tab instead of coming from other tabs. So here, if you notice, the tab value was coming correctly because it was mapped correctly from the other sheet. So it's okay. So click OK here. You see the second harmonic for C phase is correct. The thing is, we need to change the color. Change the color to C phase outline. So now we have to add the data for third harmonic. So C phase F2 is there. The third harmonic here, in this case, it is F3. I select this is F3. Moving to this particular sheet from the harmonic sheet. F3, okay. So, okay. So we will be seeing the shorter waveform. Again, I will go for just map the color, change the color to blue. So now we got selected just only one selection is left, that is a combination for C phase. Let's go back and finish that one C phase combo here and edit. Okay, so edit, and we need to select the series data. So let's go to this tab and harmonic here, combo values there. Here, okay, so click okay, so okay here. So it generates the harmonic wave. It looks like similar to A phase or B phase. So our equations or mapping is correct. So let's pick the waveform, fill data. So all the, now we have all the waveforms are selected. So let's see every data once, actually whether it looks good or not. Let's see once. So let's quickly check our waveform creation. So let's enable like all the three phase combination of the waveform, A phase combo, B phase combo. So it's also looks very nice. Let's change the B phase to yellow color. Doesn't look good. So outline I changed to yellow. So it's ABC, all the three phase waveform are there. So now you have an option like 60 hertz, 120 hertz, 180 hertz, right? So it's not necessary since the equations automatically calculate, I change 50, 100 and 150 hertz. So it looks similar, only the frequency changes here. And also we can try like what will happen if I give 120 hertz and 120, negative 120 hertz. Put the positive sequence on the second harmonic. As we see, it's a measure of phase angle, sorry, waveform. So we will put the right one. In case like instead of like third harmonic, like you want to do fourth harmonic, 200 hertz. So you can see the waveform, it like I put one. So it will put the right waveform. So, since phase angles are not correct, you remember the fourth harmonic, what is the phase angle? So it should be positive sequence. So I have to give the phase angle correctly here. So positive sequence is 0 minus 120 plus 120 in this case. So all the three waveforms look correct. So most importantly, any harmonic waveform you create, all the phasing, all the phases ABC should be in line, all the peaks. So that's how it shows like all the mathematical waveforms are correct. So I hope this video helps you guys, and please subscribe and share and comment. Thank you. Bye-bye.